Penguin Random House Audio presents Good Enough, 40ish Devotionals for a Life of Imperfection. Written and read by Kate Bowler and Jessica Ritchie. This is Kate Bowler.
This is Jessica Ritchie.
There's two of us. It's going to be great.
To those who loved me back to life when I couldn't see the light, thank you will never be enough.
And this is for Jessica, who makes every dumb dream come true. Let's open a zoo. Preface. If you check your social media feed, the debate has been settled. Yes, you can be perfect. Other people are living beautiful, joyful, effortless lives. In fact, it's embarrassing that you haven't joined their ranks already. Use this moisturizer. Lose those extra pounds. Smile at the cashier. Did you really give 10% of your income to charity this year? Your grandma needs a card. I'm not sure you've forgiven your father. Your inbox is out of control. Did you finish that degree? There is a 99% chance your children's photos have not been scrapbooked. Wait, what about that credit card debt? Your partner thinks you're selfish. Are you making the most of this? And then what about the real stuff? You cheated, or he did. You can't seem to find the person you wanted to be with or become that person yourself. You've been drinking again, and people are starting to notice. The program or job is a complete dead end. That teenager's addiction is eating you alive. Your mom is losing her memory and is miserable to care for. You wanted to be more, happier, healthier, wealthier, more grounded, but you're not. We are living under the weight of the perfectibility paradigm. Try harder, do better. Other people are already at the finish line. One of the most counterintuitive parts of the Christian tradition is its emphasis on progress when it doesn't believe in absolute perfection. Jesus alone is perfect. But we are asked to try and try and try again. We are required to walk toward God to the steady drumbeat of improvement. We have entire faith traditions and denominations and institutions who come down on different sides of the debate surrounding how perfect we should expect to become. Some traditions, like Lutherans and Southern Baptists, for example, double down on the language of justification, the account of how Jesus' death and resurrection saves us. And I mean, saves us. We were nothing, we were getting nowhere, and then poof. God rescued us from our innate brokenness. As the North African Bishop Augustine said, non possum non peccare. I cannot not sin. Other traditions, like say Catholics, Methodists, and Pentecostals, have a long practice of saying, yes, well, that's only the beginning. Being saved by God starts you on a path of sanctification, being changed by God, and you might even become close to perfect. Conveniently, this is called Christian perfectionism. Progress is not simply expected, but sometimes guaranteed. Then there are all those who drink deeply from the wells of our modern self-help culture. They take a very precious truth about faith, that we can grow closer to God and become more fully human, and transform it into a capitalistic imperative. Everything is possible if you attend this seminar, or buy this serum, or commit to this new series of habits. This form of perfectionism argues that we are capable of anything at the right emotional, mental, and physical price. And admitting to anything else is just low self-esteem. We are fine. No, not even that. We are perfect, just as we are. Look within. We don't need to be saved at all. Everything you need is already inside of you. Which one is it? Are we terrible? Perfectible? Already perfect? We do not imagine that we will settle centuries of Christian debate about just how good we are, except that we believe it is somewhere between two poles. Everything and nothing. Perfection is impossible, but transformation isn't. We can change a bit. if we really want to. This is the choice embedded in every day from the moment we wake up. We will have to find enough momentum to reach for a faith that is never perfect, but good enough. Also, dear listener, please know that we have a sense of humor. So we are laughing every time we describe good enough as implying a gentle meh. We love God. We simply know that we will not be joining a monastic order anytime soon, and we'll have to figure out a reasonable spiritual plan given how much Netflix we're watching. What kind of faith is good enough? A good enough faith will establish a sort of rhythm of life to sustain momentum. These are not an effort to ensure seven steps to guaranteed sainthood, but rather to remind us that closeness with God is not just a question of belief. It is also in the small actions we can take. A good enough faith is not reaching for the impossible. We can't be everything to everyone, or even enough for ourselves. We're human. A good enough faith looks for beauty and truth in what's possible. No, not everything is possible. But we will hunt for the places where we can find an opportunity for a little more. In taking this journey, you may realize that you are more committed to the perfectibility paradigm than you thought. So, signs you fell into the perfectibility paradigm. You look at others and fantasize about how your future self will be amazing at, insert magical thing to be admired. You are deeply frustrated by yourself when you are not able to, quote, stick with something. You stay too long in the self-help section at the bookstore, wondering if there is a secret to being better. You are confused about whether faith is a free solo experience. It is not. You are a group project. Truths we might start loving even more. We are made for interdependence. We are fragile, and so is everyone else, but we can learn to live beautifully inside of our limited bodies. Yes, our stupid, imperfect, ordinary lives can be holy. Life will break your heart, and there's nothing wrong with you if you know that. And sometimes joy and laughter and absurdity are the exact medicine we need. But also we need actual medicine. We love actual medicine too. When life goes off the rails, we often believe we are the problem. But the reality is that so much is out of our control. You get sick, a friend dies, the baby's heart stops beating. The financial pressures are too much to bear. We have to learn to live inside of a life that may not be perfectible. One way or another, we can't afford the lives we have, emotionally, spiritually, and financially. And guess what? There is no best life now in sight. So now what? In this book, we hope to carve out the space between despair and hope, between believing everything is possible and nothing is possible. We are on the lookout for beauty and meaning and truth in the midst of lives that didn't turn out like we thought they should. We can have lives where God breaks in and surprises us. We can learn to believe that we are blessed, regardless of how our lives appear on social media or at high school reunions. We can begin to feel less alone, more loved, and less judged when good is enough.
How to use this book. What follows are 40-ish entries meant to be listened to as you sip your morning coffee or wait in the carpool line or while you're ignoring your partner at bedtime. You can read them in order or skip around or use them during the 40 days of Lent. Trust us, no one is keeping score. Each includes a prayer or blessing because we believe in blessing the crap out of people, and you look like you could use it. Inside is also a simple prompt called a good enough step to nudge you toward action. No, not every transformation is possible, but yes, there are some things we can do to inch toward a deeper, richer, truer kind of faith. Let's begin. But before we do, a blessing for you, dear one, as you embark on this joyfully mediocre journey toward, well, imperfection. Also, we fundamentally hate the word journey. Journeys are for Frodo Baggins and that 1980s band who took the midnight train going anywhere. A blessing for a joyfully mediocre journey. Blessed are you who realize there is simply not enough time, money, resources. Blessed are you who are tired of pretending that raw effort is the secret to perfection. It's not, and you know that now.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.